Welcome to the Startup Grind.
Thank you all for coming tonight. It's great to see so many of you. We're here for Cardiff Startup Grind. We've had a fantastic speaker, and we do events on a monthly basis. And Startup Grind is about helping entrepreneurs and making new connections and being as helpful as we can be for everyone. So Startup Grind is in over 110 countries now. Over 250 cities, and we help people wherever they are. So, and we are proudly sponsored by the different entrepreneurs. We do have other sponsors as well. So for tonight, I've got the great honor and pleasure to introduce Catrin Archer. To introduce Catrin Archer. So I'd just like to say that Catrin, she's got just a fantastic background, and she's very helpful, and I've only met her about a few weeks ago, and I was so impressed how helpful she is, and how beneficial she offered me to everyone's business. And she's got a lot of experience, which I feel everything will benefit having, and it's fantastic to be
passion, what actually Northern Australia and just be on boats and diving and seeing whale sharks. That's what I wanted to do in school. But later on, I found a real love for politics, for law, and for business studies as well. So it took me on a completely different path for a time. And my first university experience was in government politics. So from there, obviously, got a few skills in terms of my diplomacy ability, which I'm sure people have come across, but also a deep understanding of society and industry and economics and money and how things work. So for me, I always enjoyed that. But it wasn't my last trip to Europe.
So, from your business, so the busy industry, you had your inspiration, and you had a little bit of experience about French. So, from that, what did you decide to do? And you all decided, well, maybe I can't do marine, maybe I can do something else.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, what happened to me is I was in another. That changed everything for me, because suddenly what I wanted wasn't the number one priority. And I had a really difficult experience with my first child, and I wasn't emotionally right and I wasn't psychologically right for some period after that. And it was the experience of having my first child and the contrasting experience of having my second child. That launched my entire career, because I had the an experience where I felt very traumatized and messed up on my first child. And on my second, I was empowered, educated, supported at home, with people who I loved around me, who supported me to do what I wanted to do. I came out of that experience strong, empowered, fit, healthy, and as a young mother should be. So there were those two contrasting experiences. And a midwife who said at my second son birth something about a doula, which a word that I'd never heard of. But I went away, read about this, and thought, that's what I'm going to do. That's what I have to do. Because I knew that I couldn't allow anyone else to have that experience like that. It was unnecessary, preventable, and from then I just knew that's what I needed to do. So that was the defining moment, yeah.
That's a great story. And from that, is that when your passion for business binded together with the child, or was that later on?
Obviously, my general business was something that I had a little bit of knowledge about, but I think studying business and running one are two very, very different things. I think faced with an industry that was completely unknown, that I had to build awareness from scratch. It doesn't exist in Wales when I did my training. So not only was I building my business, I was building an entire industry and an entire sort of knowledge base. And I hadn't prepared for that. Nobody can possibly prepare you for launching a business that has never been conceived. You know, it's just over the clients. It, you know, in terms of the my target market and the doers in this area, there are more women in boot every day than we could possibly serve. You know, there is no scarcity. There is no right. We're different people, we're different businesses and different services. Our target market and our perfect match is going to be different. All we need to do is be ourselves, be unique, and be us. Yeah, we need to be us. And then the right clients will go, that's the way for me. I think what we can do with our competition is see them as collaborators, as co-awareness creators, as friends. There is so much more to be made out of working with our competition to understand who they're looking for, to make the first competition, and to actually, it's not been good. I'll be honest with you, and I'm sure one of them will talk about why doers are a different beast in terms of businesses. It's very personal to me. It's all about people, it's all about heart, it's all about soul, and things can hurt. You know, when they're that close to you, there's some passion, you can really understand how competition can hurt.
So, from your such helpful insights to a professional, as you mentioned, the suppers, how do you distinguish yourself from the competition? Go ahead and say it's yourself, but if somebody is stuck with that, how do they? Because not everyone can be as good as you. Do they just need qualifications apart from the personal experience? How do they try and achieve something?
For me, it's understanding the basic principles of business, and that's key, and that's something that I brought into my doing training. It's understanding our target market. Who do we want to serve? Who is out there that we connect to? Who are we interested in working with? How can we develop our business to best serve that group of people? And you know, that could even be for a doula, for instance, is looking for other ways to be funded. If you're looking to work with vulnerable people, if you're looking to work with people who don't have the means to have private services, there are other ways to have your business funded. But you know, you can serve equity. There's ways of doing it. But I think how do you distinguish yourself from your competitors is to keep adding value to yourself, keep building your experience, keep building your skills, and make sure that it's obvious on your marketing and on your presence, who you are, what you do, what you've done, and just keep building yourself and keep believing that you can be better, and eventually you will
be. And it's the best way to approach business. So at the moment, you work mainly with getting self-awareness. How South Wales market is?
South Wales is a particularly difficult marketplace for private services. It's not the most affluent of areas, and in terms of the traditional support for families, then we have quite closely knit communities. We still have quite close families. We still have families living quite close together. So the South Wales bill for doulas, honestly, I'll be honest with you. And in terms of the growth of the profession, it's been much slower here than in other places in the UK due to price points and the target market, I guess, for doulas. So it's finding ways around that, which is why some of our charity work has gone around.
Thank you so much.
literally loads of other women in our society, and of course the babies that are there for very vulnerable as well. So we've been able to, through referrals from the NHS, provide them with support in the later part of their pregnancy, to actually give them some antenatal education. And we're striving to do that in their language as well, which is a huge barrier for these women who are just arriving. And we're also making sure that the women have what they need for their babies, just the basics of some of the need to sleep, some clothes for the baby. And of course, on the when they go into labour, they have someone with them that they know who is there purely for their emotional and physical support. So,
you mentioned the business, your business in terms of funding. Is that how do you get the funding for you?
Has been funded, so we're very lucky that we've achieved some funding. It's not a great amount, but obviously as the charity grows, then we'll be able to show, hopefully we'll be able to produce reports and produce some stats showing the impact that we're having on this vulnerable group, and hopefully that will allow us to win more funding for that and spread the work that we do, not just in Cardiff.
Absolutely.
So, the social media apps. my information. And it's great to meet you guys over any manufacturers over the UK. You think, man, I'm going on a networking group for this case of anti-business. The women who actually have that such a good tradition when you're meeting, is it a barrier to the school or internet, or they need to be not brand new in the middle, or they were the way they can kind of trust people, or they can use people as a girl, they're 2 years old, these younger and taller. These things are still so small. In childhood, this has white children, and they basically tear me into barriers, bring me between, and it doesn't stop. It's really good. And provide medical grade like this. Again, we have 6 weeks support each, and we have had to try to prepare some support in the theme, which on the family net, we use the environment line and the energy academy. So, in terms of empowering the businesses, so we think it's a business.
Very big.
I do take that into my business, and I do take that into my business ideas. I want to show people that there is more to them. There is endless amounts to each person. And I think that whether it's because they're a new man or whether it's because they're a new business, all it takes is that spark, that idea. And I think if you've got that support around you, it's only to say, you can do this, you can do it. All things are possible. And that's what I'd love to bring in into whatever I do in the future.
So for anyone watching the video, so you have to speak, sir. So how would you see your business in the future, and then you would like to expand?
Yeah, for me, I would love to take dual training to more countries, I think. At the moment, Wales has a few doulas who have plenty of time in their calendars for the demand to grow here. So for me, the next thing is to take this doula training abroad. I would love to be able to train doulas abroad who I can then train to be trainers and actually license that training in that country. And I can see that as the big thing for me going forward. And I'd love to do more with the sort of business doulaing, so empowering new businesses to build their idea. That's a big thing for me, and I've started to work with some more diverse businesses as well to look at how they can take their idea, brand it, make beautiful assets out of it.